Hi everyone, my name is Esther and this video is part of Esther's Ministries. Thank you so much for watching. This is the third video about authority and I believe that I will make many more videos. I will record many more videos about this subject because this subject is so important and it will change your life. It will change the outcome of your circumstances. These things are just basic Christianity stuff. This is not deep stuff or you need to learn deep things about the Lord. No, this is just basic, easy stuff to do. The only thing is that you need to do it. Because if you are not doing it, then you are just wobbling through life and you will bow down to every circumstances. And we need to be strong in the Lord. We need to be steadfast and resisting the devil. So anyway, before I start, this is the word of God, and with this, truly a change is going to come. So, we've discussed 1 Peter 5, verse 6 till 9. And this is the last video, and I want to say so many stuff, but I will, because otherwise this series will be too long. But I want to end this video, or end this series, to give you practical examples. Because when I've learned this stuff, I didn't know how to put it practical, how to do it practical, how to make it applicable in my life. So, and here I will give you a few examples from Mark 11. Because Mark 11 is also speaking about authority. And Mark 11 goes about the fig tree of when Christ is walking from Bethany, when he's walking and he sees a fig tree and he thinks, well, I'm going to eat figs. But when he looks at the tree, he says he sees only leaves. So he's cursing this tree and he says, nobody will ever eat fruit from you ever again. And later on, after 2 days, Peter is walking once again across this fig tree, and he sees that this fig tree is withered. And then Peter is saying, "Jesus, this fig tree is withered. How can this be? You are saying this to this fig tree." And then Jesus is going to explain them a few things, and I will speak it out loud. And this is said Mark 11 verse 22, and Jesus answering said unto them, "Have faith in God. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he said shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he said." So this is basically 3 times in one sentence. It's talking about saying, not one time, not 2 times, but 3 times. Saying is so important. So whatever mountain you are coming across, or whatever mountain is throwing at you, you can speak against it. But for instance, I've heard a lot of people say when they are ill, they would say, well, by his stripes I'm healed. And for example, I have back pain. And then I would say, by his stripes I'm healed, and I'm claiming my healing. Thank you, Jesus, that you died on the cross for me. I receive this healing in Jesus' name. That sounds like a good prayer, right? That sounds, because it's scriptural. You are saying things. You are claiming your healing or whatever. But this is not how Jesus says to handle. This is partial truth. Jesus is saying that we need to speak to the mountain. So if I have back pain, I'm not saying I'm healed by the stripes of Jesus. I will say, because every name needs to bow down before Christ and you need to take authority. You say, back pain, be gone in Jesus' name. And then you say, by his stripes I'm healed. Pain stops right now. I'm speaking this against this mountain. This back pain stops right now in here. And I receive healing through my body. My muscles are getting strong. My back is strong. Everything works correctly according to the word. Pain is not pain leave my body. So this is an example. So you need to speak to it directly. Not just wobbling a very, very nice, beautiful scripture. No, for instance, you need to speak when you have a pain in your feet, you need to speak directly to your feet, to your pain into your feet. And not just claim, I'm claiming my healing and I'm working with God to get this pain out of my body. No, this is something that we need to do. We need to be steadfast in the Lord. We need to resist the devil. We need to be steadfast in faith and not doubt in our heart. So what I'm doing when I have doubt in my heart, I would check my own heart. I would say, why am I doubting? Is it because I've wrong thinking? Is it because something said to me that goes straight into my heart, but what was not according to the word? Am I speaking to myself and saying stupid things? Am I looking to the wrong things through the television or with my surroundings? Am I surrounded by the wrong people who are speaking faithless words? Then I need to choose to get out of there right away if I want to live according to the word. So this is a basic stuff that you can do and that you can start today. You do not have to read a lot of scriptures to get this. This is something you need to do right away. Of course, you need to humble yourself, as I said in video one. That's crucial and vital. You need to humble yourself before the Lord. But we need to resist. We need to resist the devil, and we need to speak against the mountain. Not just talking about the mountain or calling everyone, hey, do you know about my mountain? I have pain here, I have this, and my debt is this large, and my job, and all those people on my job, it's horrible, or whatever your situation or circumstances are. Maybe you are in pain because maybe you've lost a loved one, or whatever your mountain is, you need to start speaking against it. Not just talking about it, but speaking against it. So with this, I want to end this video about the authority series. I have so much more to say because we can go much deeper or into the word. Not that it is a deep teaching, no. We can dive more into the word, but I just wanted to make the end of the year just a practical thing for you to start doing right away. You can do this, but you need to do it. I cannot do it for you. You need to hear the Jesus says, whosoever shall say. So I am a whosoever, you are a whosoever. We need to be as whosoevers and start speaking against our mountains. So be blessed and see you in the next year with new videos and new teachings. Thank you so much for watching. Bye. Be blessed. Bye.